In this video, I will demonstrate how to create and manage users and groups from the command line. Instead of using a graphical application to work with user accounts, we have various commands whereby we can add, delete and edit users and groups from the shell. For example, here I am going to use the user add command to add a local user account to my Linux system. So I am going to type the command user add and I am simply giving the username John. So my login name will be John. So when I create a user, what will happen? Actually, it will add some data to the imported files. Those are like etc password, etc shadow, and etc groups. So to check all these three files at one shot, what I want to do is I want to grep for user John. I want to grep for the word John inside these three files, that is password, shadow and etc group. When I run this command, I could see that etc password got an entry with the username John. It says that the username is John and X indicates, this is X part, X indicates the password field, but actually the original password won't be kept inside the slash etc slash password. It will be stored inside the etc shadow, but in password it will be always X. And the third field indicates it is a user ID, that is unique user ID that is assigned to John, and this is group ID that John belongs to. And this group ID was created when we run the command user add. So that means when you are running a user add command in Linux, then it will automatically create a user and as well as a group with the same name, and it will assign both user and group the same user ID unless you specify a different user ID or group ID in the user add command. Okay, and the next field is a comment field. Right now it is empty. I will show you how to edit this comment field. And this is the home directory, and by default this was assigned by the Linux system to this user John. And this is the default shell. By default it was assigned when we run the user add command. And if you look at the etc shadow file, the first field says that it is user John, and this is the password field. This says double exclamatory, that indicates this user was recently created and has not set any password. And these fields, remaining fields, I will explain you a little later, but for now just look at the first field, that is user field, and second field is group field. And whereas in the etc group we have John user and the group password, and group password is we never use, but is simply kept for some backward compatibility with the system file configuration files. But I never seen that this password being set. Okay, and this is the group ID that was automatically allocated when the user created. So these are the three files that will be modified whenever we create a new user in Linux system. Now what I want to do, I want to set a password to this user by using the command password and by mentioning the username John, and I have to give a password here and I have to confirm it again. Okay, now the password was set. Now let us check these three files once again if there are any modification happened to any of these files, John and these three files, it is a password, it is a shadow and it is a group. And when I enter this one, now you can see etc password was not changed anything, it is same as earlier. Here and here it is same, and etc group also same here and here, but only thing changed is etc shadow. And here in the second field there is a password entry added. Instead of double exclamatory, now it is a encrypted password for whatever password I entered for the user John. So that means whenever you run the command password, that command will only modify the contents of etc shadow, but it won't change anything for the other two files. Okay, now let us log into the system by using the new user account John. Let me open a new session to the same machine, and for the password I'll enter the password that I have set already. Okay, now I am in as user John. I'll clear the screen. Now what I want to check here is I want to check what is my home directory. Simply type pwd and I can see my home directory slash home slash job. And what is my shell? Slash bin slash bash. So I know that now my user account is active and it's working. Now I am back to my root session. From here, now I want to change the user shell and as well as user description in the etc password file. How do I do it? I can use the command user mod, and for the shell I have to use the option hyphen s, and I have to mention new shell path, that is csh. Instead of using bash shell, I want to use the csh, and I want to give a comment to this user. This user is a developer user, so I will mention hyphen c space in double quotes developer. And now I want to give the username, that is the login name. When I enter here, now let us verify these three files to check that if there are any changes happened to any of these files because of the user mod command. You can see that in the earlier case, the comment field here is empty. Now you can see that is a developer that was given by the hyphen c option. And here it is bin bash, where it is in bin csh. This is how we can modify user parameters by using the user mod. Now what I want to do is, I want to add a group dev, that is for developers, and add my current user John to the dev group. We can add new group by using the group add command. Simply use the command group add space the new group name, that is dev, and enter. And now let us verify the file etc group for the modifications happen to that file. Simply tile and etc group. In the bottom of the file you can see there is a new group added with the name dev. Now what I want to do is, I want to add my user John to this group. Let me clear the screen. So for further purpose, I want to use the command user mod, and my new group will be dev and the username, that is John. Now let me grab the files etc password, etc shadow, and etc group. So if you see, my primary group was changed from 100 to 1003, that is dev group. Okay. For example, if I want to change my group name to different name, I can use the command group mod 2-n. I want to give the full name like developers and the group name. And what will happen? If I verify the file, that is, if I tile the file etc group, I can see that 1003 group was changed to developers. Earlier it is dev. Okay. And if I check that from my session, what it will show? Developers. So it is taking immediate effect from the user session. Okay. Okay, now I want to rename my user account from John to Jock. How do it? I can use the user mod and hyphen n, and I want to make it Jock for the user John. So this command, what it will do? It will simply change the user John to user Jock. Sorry, the option is not hyphen n, it is hyphen l. It says that the John is currently logged in, so I cannot change it. What I want to do here is, I want to check all the processes by John, that is by using the command ps hyphen f, f for full listing and u for the user, and I will mention John. And here I can see that there are two sessions currently running under user John. What I will do, I will terminate them. I can simply say pkill John, so that it will terminate all the processes related to John. Let me verify once again. Okay, it was not terminated. Let me terminate once again by using kill hyphen 9 2 3 1 3, and I'm checking once again. Now all the processes related to John were terminated. Now what I'll do, I'll rerun the command, my user add command. I'm just using up arrow to go back to my command line history. Okay, this is my command user mod hyphen l jog space John. So now it works because we terminated all the login sessions. Now if I go back to my files and if I verify by the name of John, etc password, etc shadow, etc group, I have a group account as it is, but in password I don't have John as a user. I only have the home directory as /home/John because I didn't change the home directory. I simply changed the username. So that's why the name was changed from John to Jock. But the home directory still remains as /home/John. And this won't be effective until we log out and log into the system by using new username. This is how we can modify the user parameters. And final thing is, I want to delete a group and I want to delete the user also. For that purpose, I can use the command usdel, simply say jock. So it will delete the user. If I grep for jock in etc password, etc shadow, etc group, there are no entries, but there will be something left behind that is related to jock, that is the home directory of jock. In this case, /home/John is still residing in my file system. If I say /home/John, I can still see there is a directory. I use the command ls-ld, so I can still see that the directory still exists. If you want to delete the user account as well as the home directory, you can simply use the command usdel -r and jock. That will delete the user information as well as the home directory. But in this case, we already deleted the user. So I can delete the home directory by using the rm-rf /home/jock. So it will delete the entire home directory. This is how we can delete the user account. Now how to delete the group account? Simply use the group del and the group name. My group name is John. So I delete it. If I tail the file etc group, there will be no John group, only developers group. So this is how we can create and manage user accounts and group accounts from the command shell.